HIAD stands for Hypersonic, Inflatable, Aerodynamic Decelerator. And what it is it's a device that can be inflated before a spacecraft gets to a planet. And once it's inflated and the spacecraft enters the atmosphere, it will help slow down the spacecraft so they can land safely.
It's a device that pops out of the nose cone of a spacecraft. And it's a bunch of concentric tori, just inflated fabric donuts that stack up to form a cone. It's like an upside down umbrella. And the best analogy that I've heard for this came from one of my grad students, which is it's like a badminton birdie, right? The nose cone of the spacecraft is like the little rubber ball, and the tori are like the feathers, and that spacecraft comes down, it hits the atmosphere, and it slows it down.
On Mars, there's really not much atmosphere to speak of. There's enough atmosphere that you have to contend with it when you're landing some sort of payload, whether it's scientific instrumentation or humans. So the HIAD is a technology that will enable the engineers to send much larger mass, much larger payload to the surface without relying on traditional technologies like rigid aeroshells or retropropulsion or parachutes, that sort of thing.
We're doing really two types of tests. We're doing component level tests, where we're trying to quantify the mechanical properties of the individual pieces that make up a HIAD. And then we're also doing elemental tests, where we test one of the structural components of the HIAD. And that allows us to conduct a test in a very controlled manner and collect a lot of good data, which they can use to compare against their models.
We've got two full-time PhD students, Josh Clapp and Andy Young. They're doing great work. I mean, they're the ones that really get in there and do this stuff. But the undergrads are really important. At any given time, we're supporting 3 to 6 undergraduate students, and they make real contributions. And they're undergraduates in civil engineering, mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, technology, a breadth of engineering disciplines.
We were learning about pressure vessels in class one day, and I was like, well, I already know this stuff. This is what we do every day here at work. So it was interesting to see that come into play somewhere else. It's nice to know that things that you're learning in class aren't just painful to learn. It's, you really do need to know them.
The cool thing about working on this project is if you ever have a question, you ask Josh, he won't give you the answer. He'll make you find it yourself. I'm a hands-on learner, so that really helps me with class. When I learn things in class, they make sense, but they really click when I get to actually do something with that information. And that's helped me a lot in classes like strength and materials, where we're learning about stress and strain, which is what we're dealing with.
I really think it's been an honor. You know, I'm a civil engineering student here from Maine, and I like being here in Maine, but I never thought that would put me in a position where I'm working with, you know, senior level engineers at NASA on one of their most important projects. So it's been great, really an honor.
It's important for people in Maine to understand that this research is not about a professor or a lab getting some money and doing their own little thing. It has a direct benefit for students in the state, the economy of the state in the longer term, because we're training these people and they get really good skills and a really good education out of this, and it helps everybody in the long run.